finding ways to meet a budget shortfall. I'm Jill Horner. This is Comcast Newsmakers. With me is Pennsylvania State Representative Pam DeLissio. Thanks for being with us.
Thank you for having me.
We're in the budget process at this point, and you were required to have a balanced budget passed by the 30th of June. So let's talk a little bit about where we stand right now. There's actually a projected shortfall for this budget cycle.
There is a projected shortfall, and it will be interesting. We're looking forward to, everybody's looking forward to evaluating what the projected expenses will be for fiscal year 2014-2015, and as importantly, where the projected revenue sources are. We haven't focused on additional revenue sources that are out there. Folks often think that means raising taxes, but in a lot of situations, it doesn't mean that.
And we'll get into the details of what you could propose in just a second, but current budget is more than $28 billion, projected $1.2 billion or so shortfall. When we talk about the expense side, are there places to cut during this budget?
Well, first of all, there are some core responsibilities of government: safety, education. We have to identify those priorities and ensure that there are sufficient dollars to cover those. So the expense side of it is we've been pretty lean. The last 3 or 4 years, because of the financial climate that's out there, we've operated in a very, very lean way. And some of those cuts have had adverse impacts on our citizens and a lot of programs that are necessary and important to the quality of their life.
And when we talk about the other side of the balance sheet, you're talking about potential revenue sources that you say are untapped, including smokeless tobacco. Why tax that?
Well, Other tobacco products are taxed in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, and for reasons that are not clear to me, we have never taxed smokeless tobacco, nor have we taxed cigars, but we tax other tobacco products. So it would be not raising taxes on those, but an extension of a product line that's already taxed. I think we might be the only state in the country not taxing smokeless tobacco and cigars. So that revenue is an opportunity we're not pursuing.
In addition to that, changes in the way sales tax is collected. You're not proposing raising the sales tax, but a change to it. What do you mean by that?
Correct. Absolutely not raising the sales tax. Currently, businesses are required to remit 99% of the sales tax they collect, not 100%. The percent that they're allowed to keep is for their efforts to collect the sales tax. Interestingly enough, these are the same businesses that hire people and collect payroll taxes and remit them to local, state, and federal governments and have to remit 100% of those. There's no fee or amount of money they can retain for that effort. That 1% of tax translates conservatively to about $75 million in revenue. Any portion of that contributes toward the general fund and would help meet the needs of our citizens of Pennsylvania.
And Marcellus Shale and the extraction of natural gas, is that still on the table, potentially moving from an impact fee, which is already in place, to an extraction tax?
It is certainly on the table for many members of the General Assembly, because the impact fee favored the industry and was not a fair deal to our citizens. And if we were to have taxed that at a very competitive rate with the nearest state, West Virginia, we would be several hundred million dollars up today and then projected going forward. We need those dollars.
All right, and a very few seconds left, but you are looking for public participation and you are having community meetings and you want to hear from constituents about what they feel are priorities in the budget.
Yes, there has been historically no opportunity for citizens to participate, but the last 3 years, my constituents have been able to do that.
Thanks for being with us.
Thank you.
We've been talking with State Representative Pam DeLissio. I'm Jill Horner.